What's up, it's your boy Sports Wizard, and welcome back to another video on my channel. So today we're going to be doing Rublev versus Yanovsdorf French Open Day 1, so let's get right into it. My prediction, Rublev and Stretch has scored on 7-5, 6-4, 7-6 mode medium. So yeah, I think that this is the first match that I think it'll actually go to straight sets, but it's going to be a very close straight setter. Maybe instead of 6-4, maybe 7-5, something like that, maybe. But like, yeah, it's going to be a very close straight sets. But yeah, let's get into analyzing it. So the head-to-head is 2-1. Rublev won in ATP Cup 2021. Skrov won in 2018 St. Petersburg. And honestly, the most recent one, Rublev won in Rome Open a couple of weeks ago. So titles, Rublev has 8, Skrov has 0. Rank, Rublev is number 7 in the world. Skrov is number 41 in the world. French Open, Rublev won to the quarterfinals, where Skrov won to the fourth round. Rublev is an offensive baseliner with a big forehand, consistent backhand, powerful first serve that can reach up to 200 kilometers an hour, also has good stamina. Rublev's has resulted in a grand slam in the quarterfinals, which he reached in the Australian Open and the French Open. He won the ATP Cup 2021 for Russia. He lost to Tsitsipas in the Monte Carlo Open finals. And also for Rublev, this is an interesting fact. He's one of the only players to win a tennis tournament as a lucky loser. I believe only around 7 people did that. So that's really interesting. Whereas Yanovsdorf, he's a power baseliner. He has a strong serve, good forehand, and a solid backhand. He also has a good volley. And he's defeated Wawrinka, Cilic, and team before. So I mean, like, basically my point that I want to prove here is that, like, he's defeated good players before. So yeah, I think Rublev in the first time will go out just all out. You know how he plays his forehand. He's gonna whack winners, he's gonna hit aces, like, he's gonna make Skrov move around, you know. But Skrov will still manage pretty well, you know. He's gonna stand at the baseline. He's gonna use his forehand, so he's gonna be able to return Rublev's shots, but it still won't be enough. Rublev will still make a lot of winners, still hit aces, so it just won't be enough. Basically the same for the second set. But I think with Skrov there, he gets a little bit tired of doing that. So yeah, so like Rublev will just go all out, but Skrov, he can return it, and he can still hit a couple of winners and a couple of aces, but it won't be enough. But the third one, I think that's what Skrov like really tries. Like he tries to hit his own winners instead of like trying to return Rublev's winners, and he tries to hit a winner before Rublev can even hit a winner, but it still won't be enough. Rublev is also a very good returner. His returning is kind of underrated, at least for me. So he can still be able to return it, and then on the next shot he can still hit a winner. And yeah, there will be a lot of long rallies, but Rublev will still win those. But Skrov will still be playing very well. He'll still get a lot of aces, get a lot of winners, but it just won't be enough against Andrei Rublev. Obviously, we all know Rublev defeated Nadal in Monte Carlo, I believe, maybe a month ago. So yeah, I think this is my prediction. Please make sure to like, subscribe, and turn on those notification bell as well. Guys, I did do Federer vs. Istomin. I did do Federer vs. Istomin as my last video today. So if you guys want to go check that out as well, you guys can check that out. And yeah, I'd really appreciate if you guys like, subscribe, and turn on those notifications. I'll see you next time. Peace.